welcome to you. I'm Hayley Palmer. Really lovely to have you here with me on the show this evening. Now, this is the show where my guests get to pick their favourite songs of all time. And tonight's special guest, well, you might remember her from Strictly Come Dancing. She now is a life coach, hypnotherapist, meditation teacher, and best-selling author of It's Not You, It's Me. Yes, it's Camilla Sacre-Dallerup. Here is what happened when I caught up with her. Camilla, it's great to have you on the show. How are you?
Thank you, Hayley. It's great to be on the show. Yeah, I'm good. I love that we can do this from LA to England to London.
Wow, just brilliant. And I'm so jealous you're in LA. That's my favourite place ever.
You know what? The weather has been amazing lately.
Oh, she's rubbing it in now.
Yeah.
Rubbing it in. Oh, and how's lockdown been for you, Camilla?
Strange. I'm very grateful that I've been able to support my clients and move my entire business online, you know, via Zoom and Facebook and FaceTime and so forth, and been able to do hypnosis, meditation and coaching still, especially because a lot of my clients have really needed it. It's been tough, especially for people on their own. It's been really tough.
Yes.
And it's a strange time. You know, businesses are closed. It's, you know, they opened for about a week over here and then they were closed again. Been weird.
Yeah, it is a weird time. You're absolutely right. And that's why I want to talk to you more about what you do, because I feel like I'm quite a positive person. But even in lockdown, I've kind of had a few days where I've gone, oh, God, you know, you've got to keep the mindset on point, haven't you?
Totally. And I actually did a post about this recently because I realized that crying wasn't something that we often talk about. But I think most of the people I know, and including myself, we've had a few cries through lockdown and kind of almost like a release as well of emotions, because a lot of us have felt like everything, right? And I think we're meant to feel everything. I think this is also a time for reflection and knowing after this lockdown, we're not going to just go back to how things were. We're going to go forward in a new way. And what does that look like for everybody? What do you actually want to go forward with, and how? I think it's been a lot of time for reflection for people too.
Absolutely. Well, it's lovely to have you here. We're going to cheer ourselves up and play some great tunes.
Yes.
And your first song is definitely going to cheer us up, Camilla. Don't Stop Me Now. Why this song?
Do you know, it kind of just, it feels like my career almost, you know, in dancing, when there was moments of just hardship and tough times, and then I remember this tune playing when I was touring with Strictly Come Dancing, and we were at like Wembley Stadium and the O2, and there was just full, you know, stadium of people, and it was amazing, magical, and this just blasting out, thinking, wow, don't stop me now. I am having the time of my life. Like it was magical, and I knew I was like placing it in my heart for just those times when you need it, you know, thinking this is seriously special. Thank you for letting me have this experience, you know.
Yeah. Oh, brilliant stuff. But we want everyone on your feet, at home, off your chairs. Come on, don't stop me now. We'll see you on the other side of this. Now, Camilla, your next song choice, Keith Urban, Blue Ain't Your Colour. Why this song?
It just makes me want to dance. It brings me back in time to when I just enjoyed dancing before it became my profession, when I'd just like float across the floor, glide across the floor. Beautiful. Just happy tune.
Wow. Yeah, we love a happy tune. Okay, we're going to play that next on the show for you. We'll see you on the other side. Look, Camilla, we all know you and love you from Strictly. I can remember you winning the Glitter Ball trophy and just being like, wow. But you've obviously made a complete change in your life. How hard was that for you to do?
It was quite a journey. And I think it's really important to always share that it was a big journey to start over. And I sort of talk about that in my second book, Reinvent Me, where I share the tools of how to reinvent ourselves. It's funny because a lot of people thought, oh, it's going to be easy for Camilla because she has a profile, you know, she's known in the media. But actually, that wasn't always helpful, because people sort of just would look at me and think that I would still be dancing. And they didn't realize that I had completely reinvented my career and started writing self-help books and was now doing meditation and hypnosis. So when I moved to America, it was actually to start over, to not be known as Camilla the Dancer. And for the entire first year of living in LA, I made it my mission to not talk about my past for 1 year. And so when I would go into meditation studios and spaces where I would be doing what I do now, I would just not talk about it because I thought I need to really kind of start over. And when you've been an expert in something, by the way, it takes a lot to kind of go, I'm letting go of that and I'm going to start from the bottom and build up here and be a novice again. And so it was a long journey. And of course, building up any business from scratch, you know, it's takes time and a lot of effort. But when you're passionate about, I'm so passionate about what I do. I love it so much.
That's the key, isn't it?
It just, even the hard work is okay. It's okay.
Yeah.
I love it.
Yeah. I hear you. No, I feel exactly the same because I made a career change in my life and it is hard going back to, well, I sort of did my work experience at ITV and I remember going in as the work experience girl and being like, oh, you know, but you have to if that's what you want to do. And I think, you know, your words there really are an inspiration for anyone watching that it's never too late, is it?
No, it's never too late if you're willing to do what you just said, put our egos aside and say, hey, I'm new at this and I might need some help and support and can you be my mentor? I've learned from some brilliant people, both in England and here in LA. And you know, we can't do it all on our own and it's okay. Like I was in my mid-30s and now I'm in my mid-40s, but it was sort of, I did think, gosh, do I really have to start over? You know, but in here though, I had to listen to the feeling and the feeling in here said, Camilla, this dance world, this what you're doing here, is you're not passionate about it anymore. And that was scary, by the way, to wake up one day and not be in love with something that I was so in love with. And I'd just fallen out of love with it. It gave me amazing, magical moments, but I'd fallen out of love. Like any relationship, we can't help. Yeah. If we fall out of love, we fall out of love.
Yeah, things change, don't they? I think that's a big thing, isn't it? Mm-hmm. You know, and you just kind of have to go for it. So anyone watching, go for it. Speaking of which, your next song, Have It All, Jason Mraz. This is such a happy, feel-good tune, isn't it?
Yeah, that's what I love. And Jason Mraz came into my life when I met my husband in 2008. And we went to a concert with Jason Mraz in the Royal Albert Hall. And it was just magical. And actually, our first song at our wedding was A Beautiful Mess by Jason Mraz. So I'm completely obsessed with him.
Oh, amazing stuff. Well, you can't be miserable watching this song. It's so feel good. Here it is, Jason Mraz, Have It All, enjoy. Now, Camilla, we've got a quick fire quiz round for you. Are you up for it?
I think so.
Do you think so? You're going to love it. Okay, favourite song to dance to?
Oh, it's two songs that I have to mention. Moon River, best waltz in the world, and Home. I want to go home or home with Michael Bublé. Oh. Yeah, those Absolutely. Two because it's the waltz and the rumba is just.
Wow, I think I saw you dancing with Ian Waite to Moonlight River. Yeah, it's beautiful. Yeah. And we're going to play Michael Bublé out in just a minute, so that's on cue. Favorite song to drive to.
Well, right now I'm singing along to or driving to Lady Gaga, Rain On Me. I'm just obsessed with that. Oh, such a good beat.
I'm obsessed with that. That is such a good tune, isn't
right?
it?
I've got I'm that rocking in my it out class. In the car. I look like,
that's actually a
I don't
really
know
good
what.
Car song. Yeah, no, that's a good one. Favourite song that motivates you? I guess it could be that one. Is there any other songs that you just go, yeah, I'm going to play that full blast?
Okay, and I will survive.
I mean, you can't go wrong with that, can
That's
you?
That's always been my
I like
anthem.
To sing that really out of tune. favourite song to get ready to? Is there kind of a Camilla playlist?
I always come back to Girls Just Want to Have Fun.
Yeah,
I love
we
that.
Do. Absolutely. A favourite karaoke song?
Oh, I normally hide and run away when there's karaoke, but it'll probably be something cheesy from Grease or something like that, a musical tune.
with Greece, can you? Oh, we won't sing that for you now, though. Now, your next song choice, Home, Michael Bublé, as we just said before. That's a beautiful song, isn't it?
I love it. And you know what? It reminds me of all the times when I was traveling the world and I got to that point in my dancing career just before Strictly where I thought, I can't do this anymore. I need to sleep in my own bed every night. And that became my focus. Yeah. And then in came the call from Strictly Come Dancing that we got the job. So I guess the universe was listening.
Wow, brilliant. Wow, it's just a beautiful song. Enjoy it and we'll see you after this. Like Camilla, we've got a question from one of our viewers called Jenny. She wants to know, what is your morning routine to, you know, get going? Because mornings are a tough time, but actually I've learned to really embrace them and kind of set the day up.
Yeah. Well, firstly, I used to be somebody who would rush my mornings, and that meant that the rest of the day just didn't feel good because everything felt rushed. So what I decided, I think maybe 3 years ago, and this is why I talk about self-care in my book too, the first thing that happens when I wake up in the morning before I reach for my phone, right, is that I put my hands on my heart or I just lie there in bed and I ask myself, how am I today? And it's such a simple question, but actually I go into a lot of companies out here in LA, and when I ask them all to ask themselves, how am I? Some people start crying because they realize that they've asked everybody else for months and months, years sometimes, and forgot to ask themselves. So when you check in and you go, some mornings you're like, yay, I'm good. And some mornings you're like, I'm exhausted. I'm groggy. I'm tired. I'm sad. Yeah. If you get a feel something like that, like a thought that's a little bit heavy, my second question is always, what do I need to do for me today to make sure I'm okay? What do I need for my well-being, for my mental health? Some mornings, that is, be honest with yourself, you're going to have to call in and say, like, maybe I have to call a client and just say, do you know what, can we move it half an hour, or I move a phone meeting, or I decide that evening I cancel what's on and I take that evening for myself. I schedule in maybe a sauna, a hot, you know, I do a lot of red light therapy, like saunas, red light saunas, infrared saunas, a hot bath, reading a book tonight, whatever it is I need, see a friend, hike with a friend, something that's for me. And I know when people have children, this can be hard, but I'm talking about taking like 20 minutes or 10 minutes or 5 minutes to maybe sit and drink your coffee with a little bit more ease. Then I get into in my shower and I repeat positive affirmations for the entire shower. And that is just like, I'm energized. I feel great. I'm grateful for today. I'm happy. Kind of like Tony Robbins style. Like I'm really kind of speaking to myself, because positive affirmations are actually a direct order to our subconscious mind, because our subconscious mind runs our lives 95% of the time. So if you keep repeating, I'm tired, I'm tired, I'm tired, you'll feel more tired because the subconscious will tell you you're tired. If you say, I'm vibrant, I'm excited, I feel good about myself, you're putting yourself in charge of your day. And of course, there are days where we feel, you know, it needs more than that. But I'm just saying, by kind of taking charge of your day before you pick up your phone and let other people's vibe take charge of your day, it will change everything. Because if you wake up and you grab your phone and you get that email where you think, did you even read my email? You're irritated already. You haven't taken yourself serious first. You haven't said, I run my day.
Yes.
That's everything.
I'm so inspired, Camilla. I love this. I always say I do my mind gym and my physical gym. So I listen to my Tony Robbins. I do my gratitude.
Yes.
And then I go for a run or do an aerobics class. So I always say I think it's important to have both things, isn't it? It's not just the physical gym. You need to train your mind as well.
Do you know why we need to train our... This is very important because we have a negativity bias in the brain that wants to go to the negative or the positive. So if we don't do what you're just saying and take that serious and train it every day, it's like any muscle. It'll just do whatever it wants.
Yeah, this is true. This is true. We also need music to make us feel better.
We do.
Which your next song, when I saw this was on your song list, I was like, yes, Girl Is On Fire, Alicia Keys. I mean,
this
has got to set you up for the day, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Absolute tune. So we're going to play this out and we will see you on the other side. She's just a girl and she's on fire. Now I want to make a quick dedication to the one and only Tony Steed, who I know is watching the show tonight in Porchester. A big happy birthday And thank you for always supporting the show. It's very much appreciated. This next song is for you. Oh, Camilla, thank you so much. It's gone quick. We could chat all day, couldn't we?
I know. Can we not carry on chatting? It's been so fun.
I know. We haven't even started yet. But no, I just want to say a huge thank you and for your positivity and inspiration.
Right back at you.
Oh, oh, wow. And also, I want to remind everyone again, you have to get this book. It's not you. It's me, honestly. It's such a good read. So how can we purchase this? Via Amazon, isn't it?
Yes.
Yes, so make sure. We will put details on the screen. Now, your last song choice, Blake Shelton, She's Got a Way with Words. Why have you chosen this song?
Well, I don't know. I just like the title, You've Got a Way with Words, but also just because that reminds me of when I started out writing and I didn't have a way with words and I had to learn, and three books later, you know, just how discipline can make anything happen if you just carry on and you are willing to learn. And I love listening to Blake Shelton, actually. I think he has just some beautiful tunes out there and I always sing along to his stuff in the car. And since I moved to LA, country western music has just become my thing.
Yeah, no, it's fantastic. Well, we will play out that song. But Camilla, like I said, it's been such a pleasure. So jealous you're in LA. Think of us here in the UK.
Come visit.
I will, I'm so there. You don't need to ask me twice. It's Camilla, everyone. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Hayley. Thank you. Thank you, everybody, for listening.
Oh, thank you, Camilla. How lovely was she? And don't forget, you can check out her new book, It's Not You, It's Me. And a huge thank you to you at home for tuning in and supporting the show. It really is much appreciated. And I love hearing from you. Details are on the screen below. Now, I'm going to leave you with a special Osibisa track, and I will definitely see you same time, same place next week. I'm Hayley Palmer. Stay safe, and I will see you then.
Smile will bring a sunshine day. Everybody. Thank you. Thank you. Good night. Thank you.